What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the ServerListPlus Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. When creating and running a Minecraft server, customizing its looks can be vital for keeping players interested and for even getting players in the first place. With ServerListPlus, you can adjust these aspects on your server's appearance in the multiplayer menu. This is a great way to make your server stand out, so let's go over how to get started. Visit the ServerListPlus spigot page and near the top right, press the blue Download Now button. Save this file to a separate folder because we are going to need it again in just a minute. Now, for most features to work, you're going to also want to download the Protocol Lib plugin. For 1.19 versions, use the latest dev build download page, and for all of the other recent versions, use the normal Download Now button from its spigot page. Both of these links will be down below. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and make sure you're running a plugin compatible version like Paper or Spigot. Afterwards, enter the FTP file access from the left-hand menu and log in, and then enter the plugins folder, and on the next page, press upload in the top left. Drag and drop the plugin jar files into the right side, and then once it is 100% uploaded, use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. When you connect to your server for the first time, by default, the plugin will be loaded, but it's not going to be enabled. In order to allow the plugin to function, you're going to need to use the /serverListPlus enable command from in-game. Once that's done, a message will appear in-game letting you know that the plugin has been successfully enabled. Now you can check the default configuration settings by disconnecting from the server to access the ServerList menu. Here, you should see that your message of the day has been changed to a new message. Additionally, you can hover over the player count to display an extra one. The default messages are nice, but they're probably not exactly what you want to display on your server, so let's go over how to customize them. In order to adjust the plugin messages to your liking, you're going to have to edit the plugin's configuration file. This is going to allow you to edit the two messages and even the server icon. From the Apex panel, stop the server, and once it's fully offline, head back into the FTP file access, and then go to Plugins and ServerListPlus. Find the ServerListPlus YML file, and then press Edit to the far right. In the status section of this config file, there are going to be two main areas to edit. The default messages are displayed for a user who has never joined the server or if their username is unknown. And the personalized messages are for a user who has joined the server at least one time. As for the things you can change, the description is text that appears as the message of the day within the server list. These can use color codes, placeholders, and more, and you can add multiple descriptions, which will randomly display whenever the in-game server list is refreshed. Players is going to display a message when the player count is hovered over in the menu. This can also be customized in the exact same way that the description can. Fave icon allows you to adjust the server icon to a variety of settings. These include adding multiple images, using image folders, image URLs, player skins, and more. For even more information on how to do this, definitely check out the wiki page, which is going to explain things a lot more in depth. Now, using any of this info, make any of your desired changes and then make sure to press save. And after that, you can head back to the main panel and restart the server. Once you've saved the file, you can use /serverListPlus reload from in-game, or you can use the same command in the server console without the /. Once you refresh the ServerList page, you should find your new changes. If you added multiple messages, then every time you refresh the page, you should see a different message every time. If the enable command is not working in-game, then make sure to use the /plugins to confirm that the ServerListPlus plugin is listed. If not, make sure the files were uploaded directly into the plugins folder and that the version of the server matches the version of the plugin. Once that's done, you're also going to need to make sure you are a server operator in order to have access to these commands. If you get an error when you're trying to save the configuration file, then it's most likely a formatting error. Press cancel and then check your file to find where the red X is listed. If it's under a section that you have edited, then make sure you have all of the necessary spaces and apostrophes wherever they need to be. And if it seems to be a file that you made no changes to, then you should be able to save the file anyways and reload it normally. Making welcome messages or changing the icon might not be the first thing you think of when you're the owner of a server, but I can promise you it does make a huge difference in the players sticking around. It gives a sense of camaraderie that will make you stand out among other servers they might be a part of, making them want to come back to yours for more. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.